Hi, I'm Kyle Miller, a solutions engineer at DJI, and today we will be discussing data accuracy and RTK utilizing DJI equipment. Now jumping right in, let's take a look at this highly accurate topographical map. This data set has been collected using DJI Enterprise equipment and processed through DJI Terra, but how can we guarantee this data aligns near perfectly with the rest of your survey data? Well, RTK is one option. Real-time kinematic, or RTK, positioning is a technique to correct errors in current satellite navigation systems. Those GNSS systems positioning signals that are sent from distant satellites through the interference of atmosphere, clouds, ionizing radiation layers, and even more will cause positioning errors. For example, the GPS module of your cell phone may be 3 to 5 meters away from your actual position on Earth. With RTK implemented, we can use a base station as a reference to correct the positioning error of that aircraft. The base transmits correction data to the aircraft in real time, and the positioning accuracy can be improved to centimeter level. In the DJI Pilot app, you can see there are a couple different RTK connection methods. This RTK connection uses a connection to the internet to connect and receive the NTRIP protocol, enabling RTK's network switch to access multiple RTK base stations and create a virtual reference station closer to the drone. But in the case of poor or no network connection, you can still use the self-supporting base station solution. An appropriate GSD is also a factor that must be considered in the production of digital maps. GSD, or ground sampling distance, is closely related to the scale on a map. GSD is the average size of each pixel within the map. So for example, if the GSD is 1 centimeter, each pixel within the map, on average, will be 1 centimeter in length. GSD can be set when planning a flight route. After all of the data has been collected and completed, this data can be imported into DJI Terra for model reconstruction. If you want to guarantee the accuracy of that 2D model during the reconstruction process, you can introduce GCPs when setting the parameters. GCPs, or ground control points, have exact coordinates that can be used for accuracy correction. Think of GCPs as pins when you want to pin a map up on the wall. GCPs are collected, typically, by measuring targets within the site and using some traditional measurement tools. The phase-free precision of DJI's M300 and P1 combination can reach centimeter-level accuracies. In most mapping scenarios, choosing this combination will greatly decrease the number of GCPs used, especially when they're only being used as checkpoints. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to our channel to learn more about our commercial drone applications, best practices, and user stories. If you like this video, or if you have any suggestions, make sure to drop a comment in the section below.